Using this solution, you have to titrate and find out the strength of given cable of ore solution. Okay. So in exam, what you have to do and what you have to write in the theory, for theory also in the answer sheet. First, you have to write aim. Then required materials. What are the required materials? You write. Next, you write theory. Theory you will write. It is a type of redox titration in which cable of ore is an oxidizing agent and oxalic acid is what? Reducing agent. Okay. And also you will write that the end point is colorless to light pink. And this redox titration carried out in presence of acidic medium in which we provide dilute esters of ore. Okay, for normality dilute esters of ore. And this titration also occur at optimum temperature, that is 60 to 70 degrees Celsius. So in theory you write in these all things. Then after you have to write ionic equation and molecular equation, but you can write only ionic equation. So in ionic equation, what you'll write, I'm just writing this KNO4 reduce into Mn2+. What is the oxidation state of Mn over here? +7. So it is reduced from +7 oxidation state to +2 by gain of 5 electron. And this is the reason it is called oxidizing agent. So KNO4 is an oxidizing agent because gaining of 5 electrons by changing +7 oxidation state to +2, reducing. Okay, now you can balance it. Already you have balanced in the redox reaction chapter. So what is the balancing? In balancing, what is required? First, you have to balance what? Oxygen. In this side, you see how many oxygens are deficient? 4. So for balancing the oxygen, what to be added? Water. So for balancing, you see there is a 4 oxygen less, so you add 4 water. And this side, you have to add what? So simple, this equation you can balance or you can remember it also, because after balancing you can recall this reaction also. So this is the first step, and second is oxalic acid. Oxalic acid is reducing agent which oxidizes into CO2 by loss of 2 electrons. So there is a gain of 5 electrons, there is a loss of 2 electrons. So it is an oxidizing agent, it is reducing agent. In exam, the external comes and they ask the viva, in this, which one act as an oxidizing agent? Sometimes the simple question you are not able to give the answer. So better when you are doing any reaction, any practical, so you know all the chemistry. It is which type of reaction, in which one is oxidizing agent, which one is reducing agent, why oxidizing agent, why reducing agent, these things you have to know. Okay, then after you write overall reaction, for overall reaction what we do? We just multiply by the numbers to cancel out the electrons, all of you know, and then write the overall reaction. So now this one you can write, what is the overall reaction? Tell me what is the overall reaction is coming. 2 MnO4+ + 16H+ + 5 oxalate ion gives, yes, 2 Mn2+ + 8 water + 10 CO2. And this reaction you have to write in the exam, in the answer sheet even also, practical answer sheet even also, right? So this is a very very important reaction. Okay. Now by this reaction you observing one more thing, N factor. What is the N factor of KNO4? What is the N factor of KNO4? 5. You know what is the meaning of N factor? Loss of electron and gain of electron. So by this ionic equation, there is no need to learn, only you can see the N factor. So KNO4 N factor is 5, oxalic acid N factor is what? 2. Which will be used for the calculation. Okay. After ionic equation, what is the next step? Calculation of M by calculation of weight of oxalic acid m by 40 oxalic acid, which is given in the m by 40 oxalic acid for 100 ml. Now you will prepare oxalic acid. If you are preparing oxalic acid, you have to know how much weight has to be taken. So first you have to calculate the amount of oxalic acid so that you can prepare accordingly. So how to calculate the amount of oxalic acid, weight of oxalic acid? So simply you use the molarity formula. All of you know what is the molarity formula. Molarity is what? N by V. What is N? Given mass upon molar mass. Okay. Given mass upon molar mass of oxalic acid. Volume you are taking how much ml? Suppose you are preparing for 100 ml, so volume will take 100. If you are preparing for 250, volume will take 250. So what the volume you are preparing, accordingly you have to write it. So volume you are taking 100 ml. So it will be multiplied by 1000. So this is a formula, directly you can apply this formula. Now you put all the values. Molarity, oxalic acid molarity is what? M by 40, that is 1 by 40. So you write 1 by 40. Weight you have to calculate. Molar mass of oxalic acid, that you can calculate. What is the formula of oxalic acid? Anybody? What is the formula of oxalic acid? COH dot 2H2O. What students do the mistake, that also I always tell the mistakes so that you can remember what mistakes you do. The students calculate the weight of oxalic acid only this part, and they forget to add the water mass. So if you take this mass only, that is a 90, and if you put the value 90, the calculation will be wrong. So you have to know the exact formula and exact molecular mass. So oxalic acid formula, COH dot 2H2O. So what the molar mass is coming? 90 plus 36. What is coming? 126 gram per mole, or simply you can write unified also. So oxalic acid molar, sometime examiner asks also ki you just calculate the oxalic acid molar mass even also, because sometimes you just learn only. So that is not only learning is required, you have to know how to calculate. So you just add this molar mass also, water molar mass also, that is 18 into 2, that is 36. So you write molar mass 126, 100 and 1000. Now tell me what the mass is coming. I think that you can calculate and tell me. Is it correct? 0.314 gram. Okay. So oxalic acid weight which you have calculated, you have to calculate. You have to take the weight of oxalic acid, how much amount of oxalic acid weight you have to take, 0.314 gram. So you just take the weight of oxalic acid and then transfer into volumetric flask. And what is our volume of volumetric flask? 100 ml. So you are taking the weight of oxalic acid is this, and then making the solution in 100 ml. So for 100 ml you have to require such amount. But if suppose examiner asks you what the amount of oxalic acid is required if the volumetric flask volume is 250 ml, 200 ml, so don't learn only, then you can easily calculate if for 100 ml required this, but if it is 250, so volume will be taken 250, accordingly you can calculate. Clear? Okay. So after taking the weight of oxalic acid, what is the next step? Only you know first the steps. So this was the, okay, what is the next step? Then after you are preparing the solution, and then you are doing the practical. How to do the practical? Let me discuss how to do the practical. So after preparing the solution, you are doing the practical, you are pivoting out, you are titrating and you are taking the reading. And after taking the reading, then again you have to write in the answer sheet what the things you have to write in the answer sheet. Means next, which you have to write in the answer sheet, that's it. Next is observation. In observation, what compulsory you have to write? I tell you the number, because number is such a thing you always recall, okay, I have to write so many points. So you have to write minimum 5 to 6 or 6 to 7 points you have to remember. Suppose you are forgetting, only you are remembering 4 points, so you can recall what is the 5th point, what is the 6th point. So in observation, what you have to write? The first point, solution taken in Buret. You tell me, what is solution taken in Buret? Cable of 4. Second point, solution taken in conical flask, that is titrating flask. Oxalic acid. How much amount? m/40 oxalic acid, but that is a fixed amount. And what is the amount of that which you pipette out? Suppose your pipette is 10 ml, so you have to write 10 ml. Third, acid, dilute acetazole, 4 normality, that is also approximately 10 ml. Indicator used. You know what indicator used over here? Always we take indicator during the titration. In acid base, you have already taken what? Phenolphthalein or methyl orange. But what indicator used over here?
Dilute sulfuric acid.
So there is no need to add any external indicator. KMnO4 itself acts as a what? Self indicator. So you have to write KMnO4 is itself self indicator. Why is it self indicator? Why KMnO4 itself acts as an indicator? They no need to add the external indicator.
Because it
turns
from pink to
color. Yeah, because itself it is colorless solution. So where you are doing the redox titration, which is if any one of the solution is colored, then in that case no need to take any external indicator. That colored solution itself acts as an indicator, because you can observe. What is the purpose of indicator? To check the end point. To check the end point by observing end point color. But here KMnO4 itself it is giving the light pink color. So no need to take any external indicator. KMnO4 act as a self indicator. Now fifth point. Okay, what is the end point? What is the end color? End point. Or you can say better we write end point. Yes, tell anyone.
Light pink color.
Color is to light pink. That is the end point. Two more points which I have not written over, because actually you do these things. But when you are doing the taking the weight of oxalic acid, that time also you have to write two more points. Means weight of watch glass. Suppose whatever the weight of watch glass is coming, that you have to write that grams. And in this always you have to take the weight of watch glass. Suppose it is coming 20.236 grams. So always up to 3 decimal point you have to write. Only 20 grams you cannot write. Only 20.3 grams you cannot write. So after decimal, 3 decimal points are required. And now the one more point, weight of oxalic acid plus watch glass. So what you write? The weight of watch glass plus weight of oxalic acid which you have taken, 0.314. So in this weight of watch glass you add what? Weight of oxalic acid, 20.3 jo bhi likha hua that, plus oxalic acid. Theek hai? So weight of watch glass plus weight of oxalic acid, that is 0.314 gram, then you write that. So how many total points are required? I think that you now remember for the exam even also. So when you are writing in the answer sheet in the exam also, you have to write these 7 observations. So remember 7 points. In observation table, what you have to make? Serial number, initial reading. Initial reading in unit. Final reading. Final reading in unit. And then differences between these two, that is the volume of KMnO4 used in ml. So you have to make 4 columns: serial number, initial reading, final reading in unit, and the last column is the difference between final minus initial, that is volume of KMnO4 used. And then you have to write the readings. Suppose the first reading which you are doing, that is 0, if initial reading is 0 and the final reading is coming 9.8, so the difference is what? 9.8 ml. Okay, now you have to take 2 more readings so that the reading should be 2 readings come same, that is called concordant reading. So now the second reading, you can start counting from that only. Now the second you are taking, initial reading you can continue 9.8, you can take 9.8, and then the final reading, suppose what the final reading is coming, and then the difference is coming 9.8. So what is the final reading is there, you can write it with this, okay? What is coming?
19.6,
right? So, okay, so again you write the third reading. If the third reading is coming 9.8, it's okay. So if the two readings are come same, that is called concordant reading. Okay, so these two readings are called concordant reading. Maybe third reading comes same, so you can take the, you have to take only concordant reading, you have not to take the average reading. Okay, you are adding all these three readings and then dividing by 3, that has to be not taken. Only concordant reading is required. After making observation table and concordant reading, then you have to do the calculation. Calculation, all of you see how to do the calculation. If you are after taking the reading, after taking concordant reading, you have to do the calculation. For calculation, first you have to write the formula. N1, N1, V1 is equal to N2, N2, V2. In which, this one you are taking suppose for KMnO4. And N2 you are taking, all the two are you are taking for the oxalic acid. Okay, where N1, small N1 and small N2 are the N factor. Already I told, what is the N factor of KMnO4?
5.
That is the gain of 5 electrons. What is the N factor of oxalic acid?
2.
That is a loss of 2 electrons. Okay, so N1 and N2, N factor already you have seen in the ionic equation even also. Then after you do the calculation, put all the values. Okay, so now we can do the calculation over here. 5 into molarity we have to find out, because the aim is only to find out the strength of KMnO4. Means first we have to find out molarity, that is M1. Volume, that is a concordant reading, that is what?
9.8.
Okay. N2, oxalic acid is 2. And M2, that is 1 by 40. And volume which we have prepared out, that is 10 ml. So after putting all these values, you can find out the molarity M1, that is a unit is capital M or moles per liter. After finding the molarity of KMnO4, the next calculation part is strength. Basically you have to find out the strength, and what is the formula of strength? The formula of strength is molarity into molar mass. Okay, and the strength we are calculating for what? KMnO4. So everything you have to take for the KMnO4. So what is the molarity? What is the molarity of a tonic that you put over here? That is M1. And the molar mass of KMnO4, because we are calculating the strength of the KMnO4. So what is the molar mass of KMnO4? Just calculate. It is 158. So this is 158. Molar mass of KMnO4 is 158. And then after whatever the value is coming, right, and the unit is grams per liter. So
So calculation, you have to write the unit also. One is the molarity, second is the gram per liter, that is strength. After calculation, the last part, second last part is the result. In result, what you write? You write the strength of the given KMnO4 is dash grams per liter. Right? Result is okay. And then the final, you have to write precautions. Precautions, at least two to three precautions you can write. But precautions should be relevant to the practical. ये नहीं कि तुमने सॉल्ट एनालिसिस की कोई प्रिकॉशंस ले दी. यू हैव टू राइट द प्रिकॉशंस ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट कि डू नॉट ब्लो, डू नॉट होल्ड द बल ऑफ द पिपेट, एड सफिशियंट अमाउंट ऑफ डाइल्यूट एस्टोसोफोर, डू नॉट हीट ऑक्सैलिक एसिड बियॉन्ड 70 और लेस देन 60. सो व्हाट आर द रेलिवेंट प्रिकॉशंस दैट यू हैव टू राइट. तो एनी टू टू थ्री प्रिकॉशंस यू कैन राइट. करेक्ट. सो नाउ यू डू द कैलकुलेशन इन फाइल एंड आंसर शीट.